Welcome to our podcast. Today we're going to be talking about polycystic ovary syndrome and its effect on the endocrine system. What is PCOS? PCOS is when the ovaries produce an abnormal amount of androgens. Androgens are the male sex hormones. These are typically in small amounts present in women. PCOS affects women of reproductive age and is commonly unknown of. About 70% of the cases are undiagnosed. The exact cause of PCOS is unclear. Some women have insulin resistance, which is a reason for high androgen levels, and it could also run in the family. Some symptoms include irregular periods, large ovaries or many cysts on ovaries, excess body hair, weight gain, acne, oily skin, male pattern baldness or thinning hair, and infertility. Meet Dr. Mohammed Shrayyef. He is the founder and medical director of Thyroid and Hormones Endocrinology Center in Oakville. He graduated from University of Aleppo and then joined Medical University of South Carolina, where he focused on insulin resistance, hypertension, and vascular reactivity. He has completed his residency and did a fellowship in endocrinology, diabetes, and metabolism. Dr. Shrayyef has been in this field since 2008 and has agreed to be a part of our podcast to help better understand PCOS. First, what is the endocrine system?
So, endocrine glands are any glands that they secrete hormones without a canal. So they basically secrete directly to the blood circulation. So examples is the thyroid. Pancreas is both endocrine and exocrine. So the digestive enzymes are exocrine, whereas the insulin is endocrine part of the pancreas. So endocrinology involves all endocrine glands, including the pancreas, the adrenals, the pituitary, the thyroid, the gonads, ovaries, and testicles.
How does PCOS affect the endocrine system?
Do you cook?
No.
No? Imagine that you drink tea with sugar?
Yes.
Yeah. So imagine that sometimes you get sugar that's not very sweet. So you add a little bit more than usual sugar to get the same taste, right?
Okay.
So same thing. So this is like, if you call it, this is sugar resistance, mm-hmm. right? So there is the sugar is weak and you need to put more sugar to get the same taste. So insulin resistance happens when the insulin receptors in the body are resistant to the insulin. So you need to put more insulin to get the same effects. And basically, it's good to know that this is spectrum of diabetes. Mm-hmm. So when your body can no longer compensate by producing more insulin, mm-hmm. then sugar will start going up because there's not enough insulin to keep up with this requirement. And then sugar will start going up. So that high insulin in the body can cause irregularity in the other hormones, such as the estrogen and progesterone, causing irregularity in periods and causing a little bit elevation in the male hormone, the testosterone, which cause the irregular periods and the acne and the hirsutism, the increase here in the body.
How do hormonal imbalances occur?
Being a daughter of diabetic would, by definition, make you insulin resistant. Mm-hmm. So carbohydrates are not the best friend for the patient who has insulin resistance, because the more carbs need higher levels of insulin to keep the sugar steady. Mm-hmm. Now, when your body has to put that much insulin, beyond the effect on the glucose, it also has an effect on other hormones. So it starts causing this imbalance between the estrogen, progesterone, and testosterone. So the ovaries will start producing more testosterone than normal, which in itself caused the irregularity in periods and acne and the hair growth.
How would you diagnose PCOS?
Different criteria. The most common one used is three things: evidence of hyperandrogenism, so means evidence of increased testosterone, and oligomenorrhea means decrease in the ovulation, decrease in the periods, and third is finding cysts on the ovaries by ultrasound. So you need two of or two of three to diagnose.
What implications does PCOS have on reproductive health, such as fertility issues?
With this irregularity in hormones, because to have ovulation, you need to have perfect estrogen, progesterone, and testosterone levels, right? So when there is more testosterone than needed, it causes irregularity in the period. Means that ovulation does not happen. And ovulation, obviously, what's needed for the fertility, right? So that's why they get oligomenorrhea. Means that they have less periods. Less ovulation means less periods, means fertility or less fertility.
What is the treatment process?
PCOS, it comes in different flavors. So sometimes people come for increased hair growth in the body or acne. Sometimes they come for weight gain. Sometimes they come for fatty liver. Sometimes they come for fertility. So acne or hirsutism does not improve significantly with metformin. Even that you're treating the root cause by reducing the insulin, by decreasing the insulin resistance, but yet the response from hair growth or acne does not follow that well. So in that case, introducing oral contraceptives would be a better choice for that treatment, for that cause. So what that would do is basically by passing the ovarian hormones by producing, because if the hormones are produced from the ovaries, there will be higher testosterone than needed. So basically bypass that, shut down basically the ovaries and provide the hormones for help. So what that causes is decreased amount of testosterone produced. And causing the hair growth to be better.
And it's not necessary to have medication, right? Like
lifestyle, diet, and exercise can also reduce
the androgen
and
testosterone
levels
in the body.
Yeah, it does. So it depends on the levels, depends on, lifestyle is always the cornerstone, and sometimes you can add medications to it, sometimes you don't.
So, just to summarize, PCOS is when the ovaries produce an abnormal amount of androgens, or testosterone. It affects women of reproductive age. Symptoms can include weight gain, irregular periods, acne, infertility, and more. Individuals with PCOS are prone to being insulin resistant, i.e. diabetic. Treatments can vary depending on each individual's needs and lifestyle. And we give special thanks to Dr. Mohammed Shrayyef for his time and knowledge on the topic. Thank you for listening.